Welcome to a very special Christmas episode of Teach Wonderful. Today we're going to learn how to design this awesomely festive Christmas card in Google Slides. On the front page, we're going to design a beautiful Christmas tree with a collection of presents underneath. On page 2, we're going to insert a photo and write a heartfelt message. On page 3, we're going to write a special type of acrostic poem called a mesostic poem and use some of the presents from page 1 to add some design elements. And on the last page, we're going to design a simple logo for our very own card company. Now, these are just a few of the ideas that you might include in your Christmas card. Feel free, however, to replace them with your own creative ideas. And, of course, you can also modify any of the pages to suit your own family traditions and celebrations. It's also important to note that this card might take a few sessions to complete, so don't feel that you have to get it done in one sitting. Alright, let's get started. Here we are in Google Slides. The first thing we are going to do is close the Themes panel on the right-hand side of the page. Then, drag and select all the placeholder content on the slide and press Delete. Now, let's name our document something relevant like Christmas card. Remember, this document will automatically be saved in your drive. After this, we're going to adjust the size of our slide to look a little more like a card. To do this, select File and scroll down to Page Setup. Select Custom in the drop-down menu and change the unit of measurement to centimeters. Change the dimensions to 14.8 by 21 centimeters, which is the size of an A5 page. Then, click Apply. Now you'll notice our page looks more like a card. Now, go to View, Guides, Show Guides to add a horizontal and vertical guide to your page. We're going to delete the horizontal guide by right-clicking it and selecting Delete Guide. Next, we're going to add a border to all our slides that we won't be able to accidentally move as we're designing. To do this, go to Slide, Edit Theme. Select the large theme slide at the very top. After this, select the Shape icon, Shapes, Rectangle, and drag out a rectangular border. Make sure to leave a little bit of a gap from each of the sides. You can also check that your border is in the center of the page by moving it around until you see the red guides. With the border still selected, choose the Fill Color tool, the little paint bucket, and select Transparent. Then, choose the Border Weight tool and increase the border thickness to 8 pixels. After this, select the Border Color tool, the little pencil, and select a color for your border. We're choosing the color Light Cyan 2 because it will be similar to our tree. Close the Edit Theme panel by selecting the little X in the top right-hand corner. You should now see your border on your page, but you shouldn't be able to move it around because it's locked in place on the theme slide. Now that we've created a border, it's time to make a banner at the top of our card. To do this, select the rectangle shape from the Shapes icon and drag a thin rectangle across the top of your page. Leave a little bit of space either side of your rectangle. After this, select the Shape icon, Arrows, and choose the shape called a chevron. This shape is going to form the edges of our banner. Click and drag out a small chevron shape on the left-hand side of your rectangle. Then adjust the angle of the chevron slightly by dragging the little yellow rhombus to the right. With the chevron still selected, right-click Copy and right-click Paste to create a duplicate. Drag this second chevron to the other side of the rectangle, using the red guideline to align it horizontally to the first chevron. Then, right-click the second chevron and select Rotate, Flip Horizontally. Hold down Shift and select the first chevron so that both shapes are selected. Move them slightly to the left or right until you see a red line on the horizontal guide. This means that both shapes are now centered. After this, right-click the chevrons and select Order, Send to Back to place them behind the rectangle. Let's add some color to our chevrons. Go to the Fill Color tool and select Light Red 1. Then, select the main rectangle of the banner and apply the fill color Light Red 2. Click and drag a box over all three shapes to select them. Then, select the Border Color tool and choose Transparent. Click anywhere on the canvas or press Escape to deselect everything. Next, double-click on the main rectangle to transform it into a text box, and then type out your greeting, something like Merry Christmas. Click and drag to highlight the text, and then align to center using the Align tool. With the text still selected, increase the font size to about 30 and change the font color to Dark Red 3. At this stage, you can also apply a new font to your greeting. We're going to use the font EB Garamond and make it bold. Drag a box to select your entire banner and choose Format Options. Apply a drop shadow to your banner and then close the panel. Alright, let's make a start on our Christmas tree. Select Triangle from the Shapes menu and drag out a wide triangle in the bottom half of the page. Move the triangle toward the middle guide until it snaps in place and the guide turns red. Right-click Copy and right-click Paste to create a duplicate of this triangle. Whilst holding Shift, scale down this second triangle slightly from the bottom right-hand corner. Move it into place slightly above the first triangle. Repeat this process two more times to create another two sections for your tree. At this stage, you may need to resize your tree a little. Our tree is looking a little bit squished, so we're going to drag a box around all four triangles and stretch it up slightly. That's better. After this, select Rectangle from the Shapes menu and drag out a small trunk for your tree. Use the red guides to move the trunk into place. Then, right-click the trunk and select Order, Send to Back. Now it's time to add a star to the top of our tree. To do this, select the Shape icon, Callouts, and choose the 5-point star. Whilst holding Shift, drag out a small star and move it into place at the top of your tree. Choose the Fill Color icon and apply the color Light Yellow 1. Click and drag to select all four triangles of your tree and apply the fill color Light Cyan 1. With the trunk, apply the fill color Light Orange 1. Then, with the trunk still selected, choose the Fill Color icon again and select the plus icon below Custom to create a custom color. Drag the color slider slightly down and to the right to create a nice brown color for your trunk. Then click OK. Drag a box over your entire tree and turn the border color to transparent. After this, select Format Options and add a drop shadow to your tree. Then close the Format Options panel. Click anywhere on your canvas to deselect your tree. Okay, let's make some baubles. Select Oval from the Shape icon menu. Whilst holding Shift, drag out a large circle off to the side of the page. Go to the Shape icon and select Shapes, Magnetic Disc. Drag out a small cylinder and move it to the top of the circle so it aligns to the middle. Select the circle and apply the fill color Light Orange 1. Then, select the cylinder and apply the fill color dark orange one. Drag a box over both shapes and turn the border color to transparent. As before, select Format Options and add a drop shadow. Whilst holding Shift, scale down your bauble until it is an appropriate size for your tree. Move the bauble onto the page, but just next to your tree, and then select View, Zoom, 200%. Right-click your bauble and select Copy. Then, right-click and select Paste several times to create 4 or 5 copies of your original bauble. Spread these new baubles out next to your tree. Now, go through and recolor the new baubles. Try to keep the colors of the circle all from the same row as light orange one. The color of the cylinder is always one shade darker than the circle. Drag a small box over your first bauble to select both shapes. Right-click and select Group. Repeat this step for each individual bauble. This will make them a little easier to move and place. Once you've grouped each bauble, it's time to place them on the tree. Let's fast forward a little. Spread the different coloured baubles out around your tree. When you need to create another bauble, simply right-click Copy and right-click Paste to create a duplicate. Once you're happy with your tree, select View, Zoom, Fit to see your entire page again. To draw a present, select a rectangle from the Shape icon menu. Hold down Shift to drag out a square to the side of your page. Select the Shape icon again and choose Shapes, Donut. Drag a small oval donut shape just above the square for the bow of the ribbon. Right-click Copy and right-click Paste to create a second bow. Rotate each of the donuts slightly using the small blue rotation handle above each shape. Then move them into place above the square and drag a box to select both shapes. Right-click and choose Order, Send to Back. Now, select the Shape icon, Equations, and choose the plus symbol. This will be used to create the ribbon on our present. Drag out a plus symbol to roughly cover the square. Then, drag the little yellow rhombus down a little to make the plus symbol a bit thinner. Adjust the edges of your shape until you're happy with the shape and size of the ribbon. Next, select the square and add a fill color. We're going with light purple one. Then, select the ribbon and the bows and add a different fill color. Again, try to keep the fill colors from the same row in the palette. Drag a box over the entire present and turn the border color to transparent. With the present still selected, open the Format Options panel and apply a drop shadow. Right-click Copy and right-click Paste the present and drag the duplicate to the other side of the canvas. We're now going to create a few variations of the same present with different sizes and colours. Extend the square a little to make a rectangle and then do the same with the plus symbol. After this, move the ribbons to the middle of the present. Choose a new fill color for the rectangle, the ribbon, and the bows. Alright, let's fast forward a little. Repeat this process to create a collection of presents to place under your tree. If you're feeling a little creative, you can also use different shapes to create presents. Simply copy and paste the ribbon and bow from a different present. Now that we've created 5 present variations, go through and drag a box over each one. Then, right-click and choose Group, just like we did with the baubles. Again, let's fast forward. The next step is to resize and place all the presents under the tree. Occasionally, the presents won't be in the right layer order. To fix this, right-click the present and choose Order, Bring to Front. Keep making minor adjustments to your scene until you are happy with your composition. Now, drag a box over all your presents and the tree. Right-click and select Group. Hold down Shift and rescale the tree from the bottom right-hand corner. Move the tree and the presents up slightly, using the guide to keep everything centered. Select a new text box from the toolbar and drag out a long, thin text box at the bottom of the page. In this box, type out who the card is from. Highlight the text and align it to the center. Increase the font size to about 24 and choose a new font. We're using the font Pacifico. Lastly, change the font color to a darker shade of the cyan border color and then drag the text box so it aligns to the guide. Okay, time to make a start on page 2, our personal message page. Right-click Slide 1 in the Slides panel and select Duplicate Slide. On Slide 2, select and delete everything except the banner. The next thing we are going to do is add a nice photo below our banner. To do this, select Insert Image. We recommend having a photo organized before starting your card and either uploading from your computer or your drive. You can also insert a photo of yourself from the webcam using the camera option. Hold down Shift and scale down the photo so it fits on your page. You can also use the vertical guide to make sure it's aligned to the center. Next, drag out a text box below your photo. Here, we're going to type out a heartfelt message for the recipient of the card. Once you're happy with your message, highlight all the text and change the font. Again, we're using EB Garamond. After this, increase the font size until the message fits comfortably on the page. Adjust the position of the text box if needed and align it to the vertical guide. And there we go. Let's move on to page 3. On page 3, we're going to create a special type of acrostic poem called a mesostic poem. In a traditional acrostic poem, the first letter of each line spells out a word. In a mesostic poem, this hidden word runs through the middle of each line instead. To start, right-click Slide 2 in the Slides panel and select Duplicate Slide. On Slide 3, select and delete everything except the banner. After this, go to Insert, Table, and create a table that is 11 cells wide and 9 cells high. Grab the table from the edge and drag it up a little closer to the banner. Then, grab the bottom right-hand corner of the table and drag it out so it is pretty close to the border. If required, move the table so it aligns with the vertical guide. Starting in the top left cell, click and drag to select all the cells of the table. Then select Align, Center, and Align, Middle. With the cells still highlighted, increase the font size to 24. We're also going to switch off the guides here by going to View, Guides, Show Guides. Next, place your cursor in the middle cell of the top row and switch on Caps Lock on your keyboard. In each cell of this column, type out the word that will be hidden through your poem. The easiest way to move between cells in the table is to use the arrow keys on your keyboard. Our word is Christmas, but you can choose whichever festive word you like. If your word is shorter or longer than ours, you can add or delete rows by right-clicking the table. Once you've written out your word, click and drag to select all the letters in that column and make them bold. The next step is to add a collection of words that you associate with Christmas. In our case, we're going to use words like caring, festivity, family, and Santa, and scatter them throughout the table. Now, this step can take a bit of trial and error to find words that fit, so be patient and try different options if it's not working straight away. Once you're happy with your words, click and drag to select all the cells again. Then select the border color tool and choose transparent to make the table disappear. Now, go back to slide 1, your front cover. Right-click the Christmas tree group and select copy. Return to slide 3, right-click and paste. Move the Christmas tree off to the side of the page. Then, right-click and select ungroup. Drag a box over your Christmas tree and trunk and press delete. We're only wanting to leave the presents. After this, click and drag the presents onto the page and fill the gaps around your mesostic poem. Use the little blue rotation handle at the top to rotate the presents slightly. You may also need to scale presents up and down to make them fit, and duplicate presents if you don't have enough. Alright, that's looking pretty good. Now, on the last slide, we're going to keep things really simple. Duplicate slide 3 and delete everything. We are going to insert a small logo for a card company, like you'd see on the back of a real card. Our class recently designed logos in Google Drawings using simple geometric shapes. This is my logo for the Teach Wonderful card company with an apple I made using a hexagon and two parallelograms. You can make your own simple logo in Google Drawings or even Google Slides if you prefer. Copy and paste the logo on page 4 and readjust the position until you are happy. Alternatively, you might use one of the presents you created for the front page as your logo. Looks good. Now, this last step might seem a little unusual. We are going to click and drag slide 4 in the slides panel and place it above slide 1, so the logo slide is now first. This step will ensure the pages of our card will print and fold as expected. Now that we've finished the design side of our card, it's time to print by going to File, Print. There are a few options we need to select here. Firstly, under More Settings, make sure the paper size is A4, and select 2 pages per sheet instead of 1. Also, make sure the scale is set to Fit to Printable Area. Next, make sure the options Print on Both Sides and Flip on Short Edge are selected. If you've selected all these settings correctly, your card should come out of the printer and be ready to fold and deliver on Christmas Day. So, there we go, one awesomely creative Christmas card to share with your loved ones. From all of us here at Teach Wonderful, we hope you have a happy and safe holiday period. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.
Hey there! If you like what we do here at Teach Wonderful, make sure to subscribe to our channel. You'll also find plenty of amazing teaching ideas, student worksheets, and merch over at teachwonderful.com. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.